Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are joined the rest of the hour by the editor of World Affairs Brief, Joel Skousen. And I wanted to get him on to talk about the Ukraine situation. I know we're kind of getting Ukraine fatigue, but the big developments have begun to unfold. Russian troops have gone into the area of eastern Ukraine that's mainly Russian, the Crimea. They got fighter jets scrambled, quote, preparing for battle with enemies. Russia admits troops are moving into Crimea. U.S.-backed neo-Nazi party given key roles in Ukrainian government. Federal court denies First Amendment in California. Coup government in Kiev demands U.S. Britain mount military response in the Crimea. Now let's start World War III. TSA detains libertarian blogger after seeing Bitcoin in his bag. Again, Russian Air Force drills Ukraine attack plan for military invasion. This is a big development. Here's another headline. 12 signs that Russia is ready to fight a war over Crimea. I get sick of hearing about it. I'm not siding with Russia either, but George Soros' people, the globalists, are in there trying to destabilize things. Some of the folks in Ukraine have real beefs with the Russian-backed government. They had a Western-backed government in 2004. Joel, some stations join us the next segment, so I need you to repeat whatever you say now, but where do you come down on this? Because I don't like coming down on the side of Russia, but I also don't want to come down on the side of Hillary and the State Department and George Soros. It's this old quandary of both sides are bad. I go to the fact that it looks like the West is starting this, so the initiation of the coup says that the Western invasion is bad. Or what do you think?
Well, actually, you're going to get a whole different view from me because you know, my biggest expertise is understanding what the conspiracy is all about. And there's not just one conspiracy. There is a Russian conspiracy.
No, I know there is. That's what I'm asking you.
That's right. But in fact, everything that we've heard on the alternate media has been wrong. This coup was not a Western coup. This was a phony coup pulled off by the pro-Russian forces themselves to make it look like a collapse. And to turn it on its head. In other words, we got to go one level deeper in conspiracy theory to understand this is the same thing that happened in the phony coup to overthrow the Soviet Union. There's never been a coup, Alex, in the world that hasn't been done by a military takeover, except in Russia and now Ukraine. Are we to believe that, suddenly all of the powerful forces of the KGB and the Russian army simply collapsed and let unarmed people take over the government of the Soviet? It didn't happen. It was a staged coup, and it was a fraud. And the same thing happened this weekend in the Ukraine. I mean, it's amazing, Alex. No one in the mainstream or even the alternative media asked these essential questions that I put out in today's World Affairs Brief. Number one, who gave the orders for all the riot police, the Berkut, to melt away and leave their posts so that the totally disarmed opposition could easily take control of the city?
No, I pointed that out last week, but I'm going to give you the floor when we come back. That's why I said this is very confusing for me, because why did the government stand down? I thought that was because of the Western threat. They wanted to look good, but they had to know then that this group would take over. Since when do police let rioters shoot them and not shoot back?
That's right. I mean, this was scripted. I mean, who gave the orders to the pro-Russian Party of Regions?
All right, well, I want you to start over. We're going to come back. Yeah. I'm going to give you the floor. Joel, that's why I got you on, because I really do respect your view, and 9 times out of 10 it's turned out to be very accurate and very piercing. So we want to get your take on this and then tie it into the larger strategy. But, I mean, was Georgia a staged event as well, or was that different in 2008?
Well, that was different. I'll explain that as well.
Yeah, because that looked like that was really the West trying to test Russia, right?
Yeah, and well, it was the Israelis who were involved in that as well.
Yes, yes, they were involved.
On behalf of the globalists, trying to instigate, I think, but they really did have to move troops.
Well, let's start at Georgia then when we come back.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalists by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to Big Pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products and get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip.
Renewed hostile actions against United States ships on the high seas in the Gulf of Tonkin have today required me to order the military forces of the United States to take action in reply.
Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee.
Senator Kennedy has been shot. Is that possible? He still has the gun. The gun is pointed at me right at this moment.
Take a hold of his thumb and break it if you have to.
We were to run a full fast. They have got explosion and we are defending and we agree. Let's try our best.
People calling themselves members of the Weather Underground last night planted bombs in federal office buildings in Washington and Oakland, California.
They took the babies out of incubators and left the children to die on the cold floor.
Survivors of the USS Liberty are demanding a congressional investigation into what happened and acknowledgement that the Israeli Air Force bombed a U.S. intelligence Navy ship.
The death of bin Laden marks the most significant achievement to date in our nation's effort to defeat al-Qaeda.
The Taliban is taking responsibility for shooting down a U.S. helicopter. More than 30 people were killed, and there are reports this morning that most of them are U.S. Navy SEALs.
There may be a false flag incident where some ship goes down and you can be used for the excuse to accelerate the next war.
If there's one thing that has unified Democrats and Republicans, and everybody in between, things that we all hated, the bank bailout.
The Department of Homeland Security is apparently on a huge ammo buying spree.
It comes out to like 1.6 billion rounds of ammunition.
Today, it is infinitely easier to kill a million people than to control a million people.
They estimated that they would have to eliminate 25 million people in these re-education centers. And when I say eliminate, I mean kill.
I'm here to warn people. You keep telling me to shut up. This isn't a game.
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
I intellectually study geopolitics. I study different regions of the world. I like to be informed. I find it to be fun, enlightening, energizing. But the more you learn, the more you know you don't know. And the more you learn that governments do involve themselves in conspiracies, wheels within wheels. It's come out the bin Laden raid was staged, a.k.a. Cy Hirsch, two-time Pulitzer Prize winner. We told you first. Joel Skousen told you as well. I've had Navy SEALs families on whose sons, before they were killed, blown up in the helicopter, said it was staged. They were going after a bin Laden double. There was no body thrown overboard on the ship. If they lie about all that, 9/11, you name it, they'd lie about anything. And there are different criminal organizations battling for control of the planet. Three different major power blocks. I agree with the editor-in-chief of WorldAffairsBrief.com's analysis, former Marine Corps officer and a naval aviator in Vietnam, and again, World Affairs Brief commentary and insight on a troubled world. You can subscribe there on the site. We sell his big color book that's the best out there, according to all the survivalists I talked to, a strategic relocation with the film we made with him exclusively at InfoWarsStore.com. I should add, invaluable information per region, your area on politics, race manipulation, resources, threats, you name it, not just for the U.S., but worldwide. So Strategic Relocation, the book and the film. We also sell his bestseller, The Bible on Home Fortification, The Secure Home, all available at InfoWarsStore.com, but that's a side issue. The reason I wanted to get Joel Skousen on is I don't, as I've said, worship Vladimir Putin. I don't romanticize him. I know it's just a different power block. I don't like George Soros, the State Department, and what they're doing, $5 billion into Ukraine back in 2004, putting another government in. What's really going on? But we know at the highest levels between EU, Russia, the West, the United States, there's also backdoor deals, weapons transfers. China's been given all our bases, the deep water ports, the Panama Canal, the industry. So there's high-level double-crossing going on, and something doesn't feel right about all this. And Joel Skousen brought up the point that it looks like the West is backing a coup. It looks like they're funding neo-Nazis. It looks terrible. You've got so-called protesters being called freedom fighters, shooting police at point-blank, not getting in trouble, taking over the presidential palace, no one resists, taking over the airports, beating people up, and now you've got the Russians going into eastern Ukraine. Is this a covert deal like the Warsaw Pact or before that when Hitler split part of Poland with Stalin? Is that getting ready to happen? What's really going on here with all your research, Joel Skousen? What's your take on this?
Well, my take, Alex, is that this is pure and simple a faked coup done by the Russians, not by the West, because they are the only ones. It's only the Russian-backed majority rulers in Ukraine that could have given the orders to the Berkut to go back to the barracks and let the opposition have full reign. I mean, the EU globalists don't have that kind of control there. There's only one person. For example, look at the pro-Russian Party of Regions, who has the vast majority in the Rada, which is the Ukrainian parliament. They were voting, you know, in a block to stop any reforms. And all of a sudden, on Saturday, they switch and vote unanimously to oust President Yanukovych. Unanimously. Somebody had to give them the word. I mean, this is like the old Soviet days when you see these pictures of the whole Soviet parliament raising their hand in unison and saying, aye, you know. This only happens when you have absolute party control, when you switch things like that. In other words, you know, Paul Craig Roberts talks about the fact that on Sunday, all of a sudden, the Party of Regions started to claim that they had threats on their lives. People were shooting at them. They had to flee for their lives. There were mass resignations. But remember, That happened after they voted unanimously. Why would the opposition be shooting at them and threatening their lives if they were already complying and voting 100% with the opposition? It just doesn't make sense. I'll tell you what happened. It was the secret.